Samantha's excited that she's been invited to a party by the coolest kid in school.
V. Todd Phillips!
Man, high school was rough in the 80s. To be considered cool, you had to direct several successful comedies. Holy shit, it's goddamn Christy Swanson. I guess Tony and Angela are living on top of a hellmouth. Samantha gives the parents a lesson in the hierarchy of the school.
Okay, see, the cute guys are the popular guys, and cool guys are so cool, they don't need to be popular. Then there's the jocks. Sometimes they're popular, but they're never cool.
Don't forget the wannabes.
And then there's your assorted geeks, wimps, nerds, and other weirdoids. And the lowest of the low, the audio-visual squad.
Damn, that's a shot at the crew right there. Tony wants to know if Todd's parents will be home, and Sam says they will. Samantha comes down for breakfast, and it's clear she's been taking fashion tips from Charles Nelson Reilly. She's mum about what happened at the party, and Tony's dad senses are burning more than in She's Out of Control. Sam and her friends are in her room, and they beg her to see the evidence. She takes off her scarf and displays what's either a tragic vacuum cleaner accident or a hickey. They rate it for size, color, and placement like it's a goddamn prize-winning pumpkin. Tony comes in with some laundry and discovers her love bite. They get into a fight and Tony grounds her. Jonathan comes in while Sam is grounded and proudly displays the hickey he gave himself on his arm. Sam tells him that he should be doing that to a girl and he screams, "Ech!" So I guess Jonathan's life comes complete with foreshadowing. Tony walks in with food and attempts to talk to her. They have a heart-to-heart and Tony says he's worried about her having sex. Of course, this is network TV in 1986, so they never actually say the word sex. After he leaves, Sam sneaks out to go on her date. We go to Todd and Sam's date, and it's like a middle school dance. Look at that. You could drive a train between the two of them. Todd suggests that they play pool and tries out some Ninja Turtles moves with the stick. Samantha sinks several balls in the break, and Todd is obviously intimidated by a strong woman. He ain't woke. He suggests listening to music, and they start to kiss with the lights out. That's when Todd starts with lines so cheesy they'd make Velveeta proud.
I really care about you.
Because what you're doing now is making me uncomfortable.
But Sam, I told you, I really care about you. You see, it's different with guys. It's biological. I could die if he stops.
This guy must have taken Louis C.K.'s masterclass in begging for sex. Sam says no, and Todd is only seconds away from asking to masturbate in front of her when she runs out. Samantha decides to come in through the front door and admits what happened. Tony says he's going to trust her from now on, which may have been a mistake. Thanks for watching this episode of Dumpster Diving. Please come back every Thursday for more Dumpster Diving. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, check the description for our social media handles, and don't forget, over at Michigan Sports and Entertainment on YouTube, we have a new podcast called Massive Late Fee, where we talk about entertainment news and stories. Thanks so much for watching again. Have a nice day. Bye.